We are live at Skin and B. Johnson Stadium in International Speedway in Barron Gristlejock, Georgia. The Ork Jork cheering section is already in the spirit of things, I can see. They've already dismembered the opposing team's mascot. Nicely done, great fans.
Did you know that being an NFL mascot is the leading cause of death for overqualified college graduates?
Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. The Full Metal Mayhem bang heads against the Orcs of Hazzard. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow with you on NFL Game Day. Hey, Fricks, do you smell something burning?
Thanks for reminding me. I left my rubber foot in the toaster oven to warm it up. Last time I left it there too long, it came out like Saganaki. Opa! It's freezing in here.
Hey, why don't you take your shampoo and ouzo, stick your head in the toaster oven. That'll warm you up.
And it's first and 10. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about 8 on the play. Second down and 2. Not much there, maybe a yard. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. And the defense spiked the offensive water with Strawberry Fields. And now they can taste scent. Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurdle and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. And it's 1st and 10. Picked up a lot of real estate in a hurry. Give him 10 yards right there. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And this guy runs angry and runs hard. First down! It's 1st and 10. And he reels that one in for a 1st down to keep the drive alive. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, be okay.
2nd down and a lot. That run is good for 10 yards. Third and 4. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Man, what a hit that was. Oh.
It's first and 10.
Oh, and the defense jumps outside to attack the
QB. In some leagues, you aren't even allowed to touch the QB. In the NFL, they have plays just for killing them. That's what I'm talking about. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
Second down and 5.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Oh man, I love this dirty trick. The quarterback unleashes a rocket, and then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Oof. Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
First down and 9. Second down and 9. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
And he just slipped away like a greased pig. Man, guys, like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down.
And it's first and 10. Run there for 8 yards. Second down and 2. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. Third and 2. The way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Second down and a very lot. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. The teams are all tied up at the end of quarter one. We'll be right back. Third down and long. And like a monkey truck. That's a 6-yard gain on that catch. The drive was stalled, and here comes the field goal attempt. And it's good!
You know, Vin, in this league where murder and bribery are cheered, it's good to be good, huh? I mean, can't we all just...
Not this shit again. Bricks, I'm stopping it right there.
Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery.
Oh my God, they killed Kenny.
First down and forever.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Play by the defense results in an interception.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10. At the last second. Nifty move there. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. The defense better look out. The offense called the Beast Boost dirty trick. And he's running like a moose right now. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with, no mustard?
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
First and 10.
Hot one.
And he picks up about 6 on the play. And that'll be second down and 4. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. And it's first and 10.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Thank you. Second down and more than a QB. I personally think that the ginormous guy is compensating for some. And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, man. Like a haiku.
You can catch it. I will catch it.
Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
First and 10. The warning sounds, only 2 minutes left in the first half. And it's first and 10. Second down in a mile. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
It must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. It's first and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Second down and 10. That's a 4-yard gain. The timeout is called by the quarterback. They have one left. Third down and 6. Remember, folks, in the NFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. The defense calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left.
I hope some lucky fan gets to catch the ball. This is going to be a great kick.
With how hard he's going to have to kick it, they'd probably die, Bricks.
Pass me the binoculars.
Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, Hot two.
He's got his beast boots working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. And he's off to the races. First down. And this guy is a stud, Bricks.
Yeah, telling me. Nice run.
No, I mean, he's a real stud. He works at the Mutant Stud Farm weekends and summers. Well, that's two timeouts burned. And you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
Yeah, I'm speaking from experience, Grim, but it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
He's got the distance, and the kick is good. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named it.
Oh, with the brain scrambler. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. And these guys are neck and neck to begin the third quarter.
You talking about them two Siamese twins playing opposing tackles? Yeah, they're putting on a hell of a show.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
He's not going down. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one. Hot two.
And that is caught for a first down. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and 10. We know this quarterback likes to play with soft balls, but the defense, they're playing with big balls and just crushed his balls.
That's a lot of balls, Grim.
Second down in a very lot. Footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Yeah.
way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
Paper, I'll scare all the shiver.
Footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Second down and 10. And the ball is lateral to his teammate. Oh, what a brutal hit. And it's first and 10. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
First and 10.
Not one.
He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
I want to take a beast boost injection too.
Now that has weird side effects, Bricks.
That was a nice piece of running, Vin. That's a first down.
And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks.
I know. I hate those zebra men.
They're back up here on first, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down in a mile.
Hot one, hot two.
He could go all the way. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hey.
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10.
Hey.
And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second down and 6. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing. but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. Before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. And he laterals at the last second. Nifty move. And that's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there. Third and 2. Smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
Nice punt. Should move him back. Nice catch. And he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Second down and a lot. First down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. First down and 6. That's the end of the third quarter. This game is going to come down to the wire.
I love that show.
Second down and 7. Tired of the quarterback. Tight spirals. If this guy could talk before he died, what do you think he'd be saying, Bricks?
Psycho killer! Just to say, what the fuck?
The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only 2 left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, man, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
And that'll be second down and 4. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. it's first and 10.
Let me tell you, getting shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wool socks, slide around on a shed carpet for 8 hours so I could shock my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel, he got blown across the room into the deer antlers.
Second down and 10.
Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and 10. And the defense calls a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. Now this takes me back to pow. And how about a little dirt sandwich? Second down and 10. One, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last 3 plays! Talk about luck!
Third down and 6. Sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10. And Wildcats will give them a first down. And it's first and 10. And that's a nice run for a first down. And it's first and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Well, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
Got crushed. And it's first and 10. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and 7. That's a two-yard pass play, and that's not going to get it done. The offense needs to move the ball upfield. Third down and 5. And he just caught for the first down. first and 10. And he picks up 5 on that play. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. Down and never gonna happen. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Not unless, of course, you kill him.
Wow, look at that freak go! He's unstoppable! Touchdown!
Greedy or desperate, either way, they're going for 2. No one was going to stop him. That's 2 points. Some fine footwork right there. Oh, man. Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick. First and 10. They quickly call a timeout, hoping to save some time for their offense. Second down and long. Whoa, and he laterals the ball to the plate. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
At this point, they're going to have to get the ball back by any means necessary. Or wasting 2 timeouts on the defense is really going to bite them in the ass. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
Time to see if this is an elite kicker.
Can he kick through a cement wall?
Probably not, Bricks.
Then he's not elite.
And that was a hell of a kick.
Yeah, usually to get kicked that hard, you have to tell someone you think their sister's pretty.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. When in a hurry... hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Ah, oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Well, he made the pass, but then a slap in the face by the defense.
Aw, oh, that's me in the hotel bar every night.
And that'll be their final timeout. The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
Yeah, same as Britz's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a compliment.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. The Orcs of Hazzard suffer a loss today. And let's go down to the field and hear the MVP. He's a real role model for the kids, Bricks. That is, if you want your kids to be a roid-raging narcissist with uncontrollable verbal diarrhea.
Well, that personality disorder has a name. It's called auto-Trumpism.
Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...